assigning MIDI in Logic Pro 11 using the Faderport V2. Let's go! If you're new here, welcome to the channel. My name is Ole Petter Myhren, aka Subphotic. I help music makers get as good a sound as possible in their home studio, recording rap music using Logic Pro. And I want to give a big shout out to Reassure, who commented a month ago or so on my video about the Faderport 2, the review that I made. And he was asking whether or not it was possible to use the F function keys and assigning those. I boldly claim that, yeah, I've been doing that, but not specifically for the F buttons, but some time back I used a couple of the other buttons for other stuff than they were intended to. Also, a big shout out to Ivan Matkowski, who also wanted a deep dive into the MIDI assignments in the Faderport 2, especially with concerning breath control, I think, CC2, and some of the things that I'm going to show is directly translatable to that. So I hope that helps. And then I'm going to end off the video with a small caveat, or to put it more bluntly, a warning. So without any further ado, here's how to assign MIDI in Logic Pro 11 using the Faderport V2. Now, the first thing that I do is make sure that the Faderport V2 is connected directly to the computer and not using a hub. And then I download the Universal Control app just to make sure and update the firmware on the Faderport. Okay, so really quickly, here's how to assign MIDI in Logic Pro with the Faderport or any other MIDI controller for that matter. So what I suggest doing is hit X to reveal the mixer, like so, and then hit Command L. And here you get the MIDI assign menu. You may need to make sure that you're in the expert view in Logic Pro 11. It automatically comes here and it's automatically in learn mode. So what we'll do here is, you see here, show hide mixer. That's the last function that I pressed. There are some functions that can't be assigned to MIDI, such as the mono stereo button. As you see here, nothing happened. But if I open the Pro Q3 here, I can, for example, bypass it, and then you see here, bypass, insert one bypass. Now, there's no message received yet, so now I'll touch something on my Faderport, and I choose to touch the right button, because that's a button that I seldom use anyways, so I'll learn this one. So that's pretty simple. And now the learn mode is switched off automatically, and I can close this one here, and whenever I press the right button, it will be bypassed like this, on and off, on and off. You see here we have a high pass filter going on right here, and I'm moving it, and I'll switch to turn the dial here. Now, say that I want to assign my pan knob to the filter. I can do it really easily, just hit Command L again, and here you see no message received yet, Pro Q3 band 1 frequency, and I'll just tweak the pan knob. Now it's learned. Okay, so here you see I've assigned it. Yeah, another typical use case that I would like to do is, if say that I don't have a mono button on my controller, I can just, on the stereo out, put in a gain plugin like this, and then I'll click mono on and off, or on, or whatever, and then I'll do this again, gain, make mono, and then I can press, for example, bypass. So whenever I press the bypass, I will switch on the mono on this one. Or I could select it and press right to bypass it, like so. So this doubles as a bypass, and I could have this turn on all the time and just bypass it. Now I have a mono button on my Faderport 2. Now I'll just save this one. Now let's see, just as an experiment, let's just double check that when I have now quit my Logic Pro and I'll open it again, that it's still there, the function is still there. Let's see, I'll just open the session again. Yeah, still working, still got it, still working. Now let's double check and see if I'll open another project. Does it still apply? Insert one on any channel strip is being bypassed. You see here, when I press the right button, it's being bypassed. And the same goes for, I guess, I don't know if what happens here. If I insert something on the stereo here, let's see the gain plugin. Oh yes, you see here? On and off, on and off, on and off. And then I was asked to to try out something for the F buttons, the function buttons. There are four function buttons on the fader port. They're F1 to 4. And let's just check. Let's try bypassing this one. Yeah. So bypass the send effects. And then I'll do it on the F1. Okay. Reassign. Keep both. Reassign. Ah. Yeah, there we are. There it worked. It's a bit of a delay. Wow. This one was a bit unstable. So there you have it. So you can set the fader port to have different functions for the different knobs and the rotator and the fader as you please. You just press Command L, hit a feature, and then hit the knob that you want, and then it's all set. However, as you can see on this last one, it's not problem-free. Using the function keys, all went well. It worked, but sometimes it bugs and it starts blinking like this. And I haven't yet found the workaround for this, and I don't know about you, Reassure, if that's happened to you, if you've tried the same procedure as this. And in that case, I'm so sorry. This video might not be what you were looking for, but anyways, I hope that you are now inspired to either solve the problem in another way, or maybe just use the other keys that are more certain that works. For example, the right button, that one works as a charm. I was so sure that this would work, and I've tried for a couple of weeks now, every now and then just tweaking, trying, reading myself up. Maybe it's something to do with my version of Logic, or it's the fader port integration with Logic Pro in general. I'm not so sure because I don't have another version of Logic to try up against. Maybe in Studio One, the integration is more seamless and you can use the function keys more elegantly. If you have one takeaway from this video, I think it should be that some of these functions works and you should just go ahead and try them out. And if you're stuck, don't let your music making and creative process be stopped because of a technical issue. That's my advice to myself. Anyways, hit me up in the comments if anything was unclear or if you have the solution to this problem with the F keys that I stumble upon in this way. Big shout out to Reassure. Also, big shout out to Ivan Matkowski. I appreciate you guys. Hit me up again if there's something else I can, expand on. And if you're interested in other types of music gear, check out one of these videos. I hope I see you there. And until then, have a good one. Peace out.